Hey, what's happening? It's Glen Gosch with Coldwell Banker and Gosch Real Estate here with 10 things to know if you are thinking about or planning on moving to Tri-Cities, Washington. All right, in no particular order, number 10, know what the cities are. So the Tri-Cities, when we're talking about the three cities, it's most commonly thought of Kennewick, Pasco, and Richland. But there is a fourth city just to the west of Richland called West Richland. And West Richland is not just an area of Richland, it is its actual own city. And then beyond West Richland, just to the west of that, there's Benton City. Just outside of Kennewick, there's Findlay, and there's some other surrounding towns that we often consider to be a part of the Tri-Cities area. In the Tri-Cities and the surrounding areas, there is a lot to do for all ages year-round. From the farms that you can visit in warmer months where you can pick your own fruit, make your own apple cider. There's even some areas that have like petting zoos for the kids. It's really fun to travel out to the farms kind of on the outskirts of town and enjoy an afternoon there. There's local farmers markets. There's a nice one in Pasco, another one in Richland that are kind of on the bigger scale where you have local vendors and food trucks. And of course, the opportunity to get your own fresh local produce. And then there's a few smaller ones around too, where again, you can get your local produce, which is fantastic. In the fall time, there's a few fall fests around town where you can go pick your own pumpkins. There's rides set up for the kids, hot apple cider, hay bale rides, and all kinds of fun stuff. For indoor events in Kennewick, we have the Toyota Center, which brings concerts, comedy shows, off-Broadway shows, local sporting events, and other events as well. Then in Pasco, there's the track where we have several different conventions throughout the year, the home show twice a year, and there's even a daddy-daughter dance, which is a pretty big deal here, and it's a lot of fun. Another thing to know about Tri-Cities are the rivers. You often hear the term three rivers, and when you hear the term three rivers, that is talking about the Columbia River, the Yakima River, and the Snake River. Now, with these rivers brings the opportunity for fishing and boating in the warmer months. There's many people that do kayaking and paddle boarding and even just take a nice swim in the warm months as well. And then beyond swimming and actually jumping into the water, there's paths along the river, a few parks. It makes for a nice area just to take a stroll and enjoy the scenery. There's also a group that puts on marathons and triathlons if you're into that sort of thing. Then there is the mountains of Tri-Cities, and I should say mountains of Tri-Cities. When I first moved here, everybody was talking about this Badger Mountain, and I'm like, okay, where is this Badger Mountain? Is it like 30 miles outside of town or something? And people are saying, no, it's right in the middle of town. Haven't you seen it? So people here call hills mountains. So there's Badger Mountain, there's Candy Mountain, and a few others in the area. And while they might not technically be mountains, they do make for some nice hiking trails. And if you get to the top, provide some excellent views of the city, the rolling hills, and the rivers. In Tri-Cities, we have great local wine and beer. And it kind of makes sense because in the Columbia Valley, we grow a ton of hops and there are a ton of vineyards growing wine grapes. So we get it fresh right in our backyard. So it makes for some awesome local brews and awesome local wines. And even if drinking alcohol is not your thing, there are some local brew pubs which have excellent food. And then wineries amongst the vineyards that have a kind of a romantic or just peaceful area to enjoy a nice meal. Which brings me to another thing to know about Tri-Cities. We have great local restaurants. Everything from mom and pop diners to cafes. I mentioned the brew pubs and wineries with restaurants. We also have awesome food trucks. Now, when I first moved to Tri-Cities, I was looking on different websites for the best restaurants in Tri-Cities, and like three of them were food trucks. I was like, you got to be kidding me. Are the restaurants here that bad that food trucks are the best restaurants or places to eat in town? And really, it's taken nothing away from the restaurants here in town. It's just the food trucks are that good. Some of them have become so popular that they have opened up brick and mortar locations as well. Here in Tri-Cities, in recent years, we've had steady growth and development. And with the growth and development brings some awesome new neighborhoods. Now, one thing that I personally enjoy about the new neighborhoods around town is that many of them are not just one builder, but several builders building in within a neighborhood or even on the same street. So you get character from home to home. Things kind of flow together pretty nicely, but it also mixes it up to where things aren't just cookie cutter homes everywhere. Now, something else to know about Tri-Cities are the job opportunities in the area. Now, it's no big secret that the Hanford site employs thousands of people. There is quite a bit of research here in Tri-Cities that goes beyond the Hanford site itself as well. Other major employers of the area are industries of food processing and food distribution. Outside of the immediate Tri-Cities, you see a lot of agriculture. Other major employers of the area include the healthcare industry, education, and construction. Okay, so what else to know about Tri-Cities is we truly have four seasons here. Summer months are generally warm, sometimes pretty hot, but luckily most homes here have air conditioning. In fall, we have mostly mild temperatures, and you will get to see the fall colors with different trees, the leaves falling, the oranges, the yellows, the browns. Winter is generally cool, sometimes darn right cold, and in some years we might get a couple of inches of snow, and some years a couple feet of snow. Spring is awesome, again with mild temperatures. You'll see trees blooming, people planting flowers in their yards. Many people have their own fruit trees in their backyard and plant their own vegetable gardens as well. And throughout the year, we do get quite a bit of sunshine. There's some debate as to how many days of sunshine we actually get, but for the most part, it is pretty nice weather here in Tri-Cities. You might have a few weeks in winter where things are kind of cold, snowy, and a pain in the butt, and a few weeks in summer where things are hot, but overall, the weather is pretty nice here in Tri-Cities. All right, and one last thing in this video to cover about Tri-Cities is the awesome sunsets. With the mix of weather and different seasons that bring partly cloudy skies, it makes for some pretty dramatic sunrises and sunsets. They're great to enjoy if you're taking a walk along the river, hiking up Badger Mountain, or just enjoying from your backyard. Some days my social media accounts are just full of sunset pictures from people around town taking shots of different areas where you get the dramatic sunsets. All right, once again, I'm Glen Gosch, Realtor and Broker with Coldwell Banker and Gosch Real Estate. If you are looking to move to Tri-Cities and have any questions, I'll have my contact information above or below this video, depending on what format or what device you are watching it on. I would love to help you find a home and make Tri-Cities your home.